Hello everyone. Today we discuss about ecosystem structure and functions. Table of contents are as introduction, structure and functions. Now first of all we learn about what is ecosystem. An organism is always in the state of perfect balance with the environment. The environment literally means the surroundings. The environment refers to the things and conditions around the organism which directly or indirectly influence the life and development of the organism and their populations. The concept of ecosystem was first put forth by A.G. Tansley in 1935. Ecosystem is the major ecological unit. It has both structure and functions. The structure is related to species diversity. The more complex is the structure, the greater is the diversity of the species in the ecosystem. The function of ecosystems are related to the flow of energy and cycling of materials through structured components of the ecosystem. According to Woodbury in 1954, ecosystem is a complex in which habitat, plants and animals are considered as one interesting unit. The materials and energy of one passing in and out of the others. According to E.P. Odum, the ecosystem is the basic functional unit of organisms and their environmental interacting with each other and with their own components. An ecosystem may be conceived and studied in the habitats of various sizes as 1 square meter of grassland, a pool, a large lake, a large tract of forest, balanced aquarium, a certain area of river and ocean. Organism and environment are two non-separable factors. Organisms interact with each other and also with the physical conditions that are present in their habitats. All the ecosystems of the earth are connected to one another. As river ecosystem is connected with the ecosystem of ocean, and a small ecosystem of dead logs is a part of large ecosystem of a forest. A complete self-sufficient ecosystem is rarely found in nature, but situations approaching self-sufficiency may occur. Structure of ecosystem. The structure of an ecosystem is basically a description of the organisms and physical features of environment, including the amount and distribution of nutrients in a particular habitat. It also provides information regarding the range of climatic conditions prevailing in the area. From the structural point of view, all ecosystems consist of two basic components, abiotic components and biotic components. Abiotic components, ecological relationships are manifested in physicochemical environment. Abiotic component of ecosystem includes basic inorganic elements and compounds such as soil, water, oxygen, calcium carbonates, phosphates and a variety of organic compounds as means by product of organic activities or death of an organism. It also includes such physical factors and ingredients as moisture, wind currents and solar radiations. Radiant energy of sun is the only significant energy source for an ecosystem. The amount of non-living components such as carbon, phosphorus, nitrogen, etc. that are present at any given time is known as standing state or standing quantity. The biotic components includes all living organisms present in the environmental system. From nutrition point of view, the biotic components can be grouped into two basic components, autotrophic components and heterotrophic components. The autotrophic components include all green plants which fix the radiant energy of sun and forming food from inorganic substances. The heterotrophic components include non-green plants and all animals which take food from autotrophs. So, biotic component of an ecosystem can be described under the following three heads: producers or autotrophic components, consumers and decomposers or reducers, and transformers. The amount of biomass at any time in an ecosystem is known as standing crop, which is usually expressed as fresh weight, dry weight, or as free energy in terms of calories or meter. Now, producers or autotrophic elements. The producers are the autotrophic elements, mainly green plants. They use radiant energy of sun in photosynthetic process, whereby carbon dioxide is assimilated and the light energy is converted into chemical energy. The chemical energy is actually locked up in the energy rich carbon compounds. Oxygen is evolved as byproduct in the photosynthesis process. This oxygen is used in respiration by all living things. Algae and other hydrophytes of a pond, grasses of the field, trees of the forests are examples of producers. Chemosynthetic bacteria and carotenoid bearing purple bacteria that also assimilate carbon dioxide with the energy of sunlight, but only in the presence of organic compounds, also belong to this category. The term producer is misleading one, because in an energy context, producers produce carbohydrate and not energy, since they convert or transduce the radiant energy into chemical form. So, E. J. Cormondi suggests better alternative terms, converters or transducers, in place of producers, because of wide use the term producer is still retained. Now, consumers. Those living members of ecosystem which consume the food synthesized by producers are called consumers. Under this category are included all kinds of animals that are found in an ecosystem. There are different classes or categories of consumers, such as primary consumers, secondary consumers, tertiary consumers, and parasites, scavengers, and saprobes. Now, primary consumer. These are the graphical representation of components of an ecosystem: radiant energy, autotrophs, and heterotrophs. Primary consumers. These are purely herbivores, animals that are dependent for their food on producers or green plants: insects, rodents, rabbit, deer, cow, buffalo, goat are some of the common herbivores in the terrestrial ecosystem, and small crustaceans, mollusks, etc. in the aquatic habitat. Elton in 1939 named herbivores of ecosystem as key industry animals. The herbivores serve as the chief food source for carnivores. Secondary consumers. These are carnivores and omnivores. Carnivores are flesh eating animals And the omnivores are the animals that are adapted to consume herbivores as well as plants as their food. Examples of secondary consumers are sparrow, crow, fox, wolves, dogs, cats, snakes, etc. Tertiary consumers. These are the top carnivores which prey upon other carnivores, omnivores and herbivores. Lions, tigers, hawk, vulture, etc. are considered as tertiary or top consumers. Besides different classes of consumers, the parasites, scavengers and saprobes are also included in the consumers. The parasitic plants and animals utilize the living tissues of different plants and animals. The scavengers and saprobes utilize dead remains of animals and plants as their food. Decomposers and transformers. Decomposers and transformers are the living component of the ecosystem and they are fungi and bacteria. Decomposers attack the dead remains of producers and consumers and degrade the complex organic substances into simpler compounds. The simple organic matters are then attacked by another kind of bacteria, the transformers, which change these organic compounds into the inorganic forms that are suitable for reuse by producers or green plants. The decomposers and transformers play a very important role in maintaining the dynamic nature of ecosystems. Now, function of an ecosystem. Ecosystem function is the capacity of natural processes and components to provide goods and services that satisfy human needs either directly or indirectly. Ecosystem functions are a subset of ecological processes and ecosystem structures. Each function is the result of natural processes of the total ecological subsystem of which it's a part. Natural processes, in turn, are the result of complex interactions between biotic and abiotic components of ecosystems through the universal driving forces of matter and energy. There are four primary groups of ecosystem functions: regulatory functions, habitat functions, production functions and information functions. This grouping concerns all ecosystems, not only for forests. General characterization of ecosystem functions are: regulatory functions. This group of functions relates to the capacity of natural and semi-natural ecosystems to regulate essential ecological processes and life support systems through biogeochemical cycles and other biospheric processes. In addition to maintaining the ecosystem and biosphere health, these regulatory functions provide many services that have direct and indirect benefits to humans, such as cleaning of air, water and soil, and biological control services. Second one is habitat functions. Natural ecosystems provide refuge and reproduction habitat to wild plants and animals and thereby contribute to the in situ, means in situation, conservation of biological and genetic diversity and the evolutionary process. Production functions. Photosynthesis and nutrient uptake by autotrophs converts energy, carbon dioxide, water and nutrients into a wide variety of carbohydrate structures, which are then used by secondary producers to create an even larger variety of living biomass. This broad diversity in carbohydrate structures provide many ecosystems goods for human consumption, ranging from food and raw materials to energy resources and genetic material. And in the last, information functions. Since most of human evolution took place within the context of an undomesticated habitat, natural ecosystems contribute to the maintenance of human health by providing opportunities for reflection, spiritual enrichment, cognitive development, recreation, and aesthetic experience. So, an ecosystem is a discrete, structural, functional, and life-sustaining environmental system. The environmental system consists of biotic and abiotic components in a habitat. Biotic component of the ecosystem includes living organisms, plants, animals, and microbes. And abiotic components includes inorganic matter and energy. Abiotic components provide the matrix for the synthesis and perpetuation of organic components, means protoplasm. The synthesis and perpetuation processes involves energy exchange, and this energy comes from the sun in the form of light or solar energy. Thank you.